Welcome back. Problem 1-38. This problem is taken from chapter number 3, Mechanical Properties of Material, and book name is Mechanics of Material by Rc Hibbeler. So statement of problem is the two members used in construction of an aircraft fuselage are joined together using 30 degree fish mouth weld. Determine the average normal and average shear stress on the plane of each weld. Assume each inclined plane supports a horizontal force of 800 pound load. So you can see these are the two parts that are joined together by this 30 degree fish mouth weld, and there is a 800 pound load is applied. Clear? And it is given that assume each inclined plane supports a horizontal face. So this horizontal face and this horizontal face. So this 400 pounds and this also supports 400 pounds, which makes total 800 pounds. So you have to determine the normal stress and the average shear stress on this plane. So let's start with the solution. So what will be the first step is that if you cut these two joints, so I will draw the free body diagram. It will be like this. Clear? Let me draw it again. It will be like this. Again, you can see if I draw it in three dimension, so it will be like this one there, and this will be this inclined face. Similarly, the force that is perpendicular on this will be equal to normal force, and it is represented as N, and the force on this plane will be the shear force. Let this will be equal to V. Clear? And our coordinate will be this. Let this is X dash, new X is, and this is Y dash. Now it is given that this face will experience 400 pound. So this is 400. Similarly, the lower one will also face 400 pounds. And on this face, we will be having a shear force like this. Clear? And normal force like this. This is N and this is V. So we are going to find this shear force V and N on this inclined plane. So for that, we will apply equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces, first we will find along X dash direction must be equal to zero, and force in this direction is taken as positive. Now you can see this is making an angle of 30 degree at this point. So here alternate angle, this will be also 30 degree. So I will write it here that this angle is 30 degree. Now this 30 degree is along this horizontal line. So if you draw a line parallel to this over here, so this angle will be also 30 degree. So I will draw a line parallel to this. It will be also 30 degree. Now this 400 pound will have two component. One along X dash direction, which is equal to which is this one, and the other one is along opposite to Y dash. So this component will be equal to 400 into cos of 30 degree, and this vertical component will be equal to 400 into sine of 30 degree. Now we can use this equation of equilibrium. So you can see here that along X dash direction, one force is this one, which is V, and that is minus V because it is opposite to this X dash direction. So I will write minus V. The other force along X dash direction is this one, which is 400 into cos of 30. So I will write plus 400 into cos of 30 degree is equal to zero. Okay. So what we will do is that we will get this V is equal to 400 into cos of 30 degree, and this V will be shear force. Average shear force on this inclined plane comes out to be 346.41 pounds. So this is the first value. This is the average shear force. Now what about N? So we will use another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along Y dash direction must be equal to zero, and n in this dash, n dash in this direction will be taken as positive. So y dash in this direction is taken as positive. Now you can see here the one force in y dash direction is this one, which is n, and other force which is this one, 400 into sine of 30, that is in opposite direction. So I will write n minus 400 into sine of 30 is equal to 0. So from here we will get this n is equal to 400 into sine of 30 degree, and when you calculate it, it will be equal to 200 pounds. Now you have this shear force and normal force on this inclined plane, and we have been asked to find the average shear stress and average normal stress. So we know that average normal stress is equal to shear normal force divided by the area that is perpendicular to that, and shearing stress is equal to shear force and the area that is parallel to this shear force. And here we can see that this is the area, this pink color area, let this area is A dash, clear? So if you take this area, this is the A, let this is A, and you can see here from this to this, this height is 1 and this is 1.5. So this is the area, and that is equal to 1.5 multiplied by 1. Clear? So how we'll find this A dash? So A, if you take sine of theta or sine of 30 degree, it is equal to perpendicular. Perpendicular is this plane. Clear? This yellow one, orange one is perpendicular plane. So that will be equal to A divided by hypotenuse plane, which is A dash. So from here, A dash will be equal to A over sine of 30 degree. Now A dash is equal to A is given as 1.5 multiplied by 1 divided by sine of 30 degree. So here this normal stress will be equal to normal load divided by the plane perpendicular to the normal load, and shear stress will be equal to shear force and the plane that is parallel to the shear force. So this will become equal to A dash. So first we will find normal stress. So normal stress is equal to N over A dash. A dash is the area that is perpendicular to this normal force. So N is 200 pounds divided by area is 1.5 multiplied by 1 divided by sine of 20 degree, and that is equal to 200. This below term will give you 3. This is 3 square inch. So when you divide it, so you will get normal stress will be equal to 66.7 pounds per square inch, or you can see normal stress is equal to 66.7 psi. PSI stand for pound per square inch. Similarly, you can find the shearing stress. Shearing stress is equal to shear force over shearing area. So shear force is 346.41 divided by shearing area is 3. So when you calculate, it will be 115 pound per square inch. Or we can say that shear stress is 115 psi. So these are the answer of our question. The average normal stress is 66.7 psi, and average shearing stress is 115 psi on each of these planes. So this is the shear force and this is the normal force. Similarly, the same normal force and shear force will act on this inclined plane. And that was all about this problem 1-38. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.